The trachea, commonly known as the windpipe, is a vital part of the respiratory system, serving as the main conduit for air to move from the nose and mouth to the lungs. Various conditions can affect the trachea, impacting respiratory function and overall health, which is what we're going to discuss in this video, so keep watching if you want to learn more. The trachea is a cylindrical tube made of rings and cartilage, which are connected by muscles and ligaments. These cartilage rings maintain the trachea's shape, preventing it from collapsing and ensuring an unobstructed passage for air. The trachea begins just under the larynx and extends down behind the sternum, where it then divides into two smaller tubes called the bronchi, each leading to a lung. The inner lining of the trachea is composed of ciliated epithelial cells and mucus-producing cells. This lining plays a vital role in the respiratory defense system. The mucus traps inhaled particles like dust and microbes, while the tiny hair-like projections known as cilia move these trapped particles upward toward the larynx, where they can be coughed out or swallowed. This mechanism is essential in keeping the lungs clear of contaminants and preventing respiratory infections. An interesting aspect of the trachea is its ability to adjust its diameter, allowing more air to pass through during intense physical activity and less during rest. This adjustment is made possible by the trachealis muscle, which spans the gap between the ends of the cartilage rings at the back of the trachea. When this muscle contracts, it narrows the trachea, and when it relaxes, the trachea widens. Moreover, the trachea's position in the neck makes it susceptible to injury, and its role in air passage means that any obstruction, whether from swelling due to an allergic reaction, compression from outside, or an ingested object, can be life-threatening. Therefore, understanding and maintaining the health of the trachea is essential for overall respiratory health. As previously mentioned, there are several conditions that may affect the trachea, including the following. First on our list is tracheitis. Tracheitis is an inflammation of the trachea, often characterized by a bacterial infection following an initial viral infection of the upper respiratory tract. This condition can cause severe breathing difficulties and a barking cough resembling symptoms of croup. The most common cause of bacterial tracheitis is Staphylococcus aureus. Patients typically exhibit symptoms like high fever, difficulty breathing, hoarseness, and stridor, a high-pitched wheezing sound indicative of airway obstruction. Tracheitis is more common in children but can affect adults, particularly those with weakened immune systems. Treatment usually involves antibiotics to combat the bacterial infection and sometimes requires hospitalization for close monitoring and supportive care, including oxygen therapy or breathing support in severe cases. Number 2. Tracheal stenosis. Tracheal stenosis refers to the narrowing of the trachea, which restricts airflow and makes breathing difficult. This condition can be present at birth or acquired later in life. Acquired tracheal stenosis is often a result of prolonged intubation or tracheostomy, where the insertion of tubes causes scarring and narrowing of the trachea. Other causes include trauma, autoimmune disorders, or infections. Symptoms vary depending on the severity of the narrowing and may include shortness of breath, especially during exercise, wheezing, coughing, and stridor. Diagnosis is usually made through imaging studies like CT scans and direct visualization during bronchoscopy. Treatment options vary from surgical interventions such as tracheal resection or balloon tracheoplasty to non-surgical methods like steroid injections or stent placement, depending on the underlying cause and severity of the stenosis. Number 3. Tracheomalacia. Tracheomalacia is a condition characterized by the weakening and floppiness of the tracheal walls. This weakness causes the trachea to collapse, particularly when breathing out, leading to airway obstruction and difficulty in clearing secretions. Tracheomalacia can be congenital, often associated with developmental anomalies like esophageal atresia, or can develop later in life due to chronic infection, prolonged intubation, external compression, or chest surgery. Symptoms include a high-pitched or noisy breathing, aka stridor, recurrent respiratory infections, cough, and in severe cases, breathing difficulties that may require emergency intervention. Diagnosis is typically made through bronchoscopy, which allows direct visualization of the trachea. Management varies based on severity, ranging from conservative monitoring and treating associated conditions to surgical interventions like aortopexy or tracheal stenting to support and stabilize the tracheal walls. Number 4. Tracheoesophageal Fistula. A tracheoesophageal fistula is an abnormal connection between the trachea and the esophagus. This condition is most commonly congenital. often presenting alongside esophageal atresia, where the esophagus does not form properly. However, it can also occur later in life due to trauma, cancer, or following surgical procedures involving the esophagus or trachea. In newborns, symptoms include coughing, choking, and cyanosis during feeding, and in adults, recurrent respiratory infections, coughing, and difficulty swallowing. A tracheoesophageal fistula allows food and saliva to enter the lungs, leading to aspiration, pneumonia, and other respiratory complications. Diagnosis is typically made through imaging studies and endoscopic evaluations. Treatment usually involves surgical correction to separate the trachea and esophagus and repair the fistula, which is critical to prevent life-threatening complications. In adults, non-surgical options like stent placement may be considered depending on the underlying cause and patient's overall health. Number 5, tracheal tumors. Tumors in the trachea are relatively rare and can be benign or malignant. Benign tumors, such as papillomas or chondromas, typically grow slowly and might not cause symptoms until they are large enough to obstruct the airway. Malignant tumors, like squamous cell carcinoma or adenoid cystic carcinoma, are more aggressive and can invade surrounding tissues. Symptoms of tracheal tumors include difficulty breathing, wheezing, coughing, sometimes with blood, and recurrent respiratory infections. The symptoms often mimic those of more common respiratory conditions, which can lead to delays in diagnosis. Diagnostic tools include imaging studies like CT scans and bronchoscopy. Treatment depends on the type, size, and location of the tumor, as well as the overall health of the patient. Options may include surgical removal of the tumor, radiation therapy, chemotherapy, or a combination of these. In some cases, palliative care to relieve symptoms and improve quality of life is the main focus of treatment. Number 6, foreign bodies in the trachea. The inhalation of foreign objects into the trachea is a significant and potentially life-threatening event, particularly common in young children. Objects like small toys, food particles, or other small items can become lodged in the trachea, causing partial or complete airway obstruction. Symptoms include sudden onset of coughing, choking, inability to speak or breathe, wheezing, and in severe cases, cyanosis. Therefore, immediate medical attention is crucial. The Heimlich maneuver or back blows may be used to dislodge the object in emergency situations. In a medical setting, bronchoscopy is often employed both to confirm the presence of a foreign body and to remove it. Prevention, especially in children, involves supervision and keeping small objects out of reach. Number 7, tracheal trauma. Tracheal trauma can result from either blunt or penetrating injuries to the neck and chest. This can occur due to accidents, falls, sports injuries, or acts of violence. The trachea's susceptibility to injury stems from its location and relatively exposed position in the neck. Symptoms of tracheal trauma vary depending on the severity and type of injury, but may include pain, difficulty breathing, hoarseness, coughing up blood, swelling in the neck, and subcutaneous emphysema. Tracheal trauma is a medical emergency due to the risk of airway obstruction and respiratory failure. Immediate medical attention is crucial, and treatment often involves securing the airway, possibly through intubation or tracheostomy, and addressing the underlying injury, which may require surgical repair. The prognosis depends on the extent of the injury and the speed of medical intervention. Number 8, gastroesophageal reflux disease. GERD is a condition where stomach acid frequently flows back into the esophagus, the tube connecting the mouth and stomach. This backwash can irritate the lining of the esophagus and, in some cases, affect the trachea. When stomach acid enters the trachea, it can cause inflammation and spasm, leading to symptoms like chronic cough, hoarseness, or worsening of asthma symptoms. This condition, known as laryngopharyngeal reflux, is a variant of GERD and can impact the trachea and larynx. Diagnosis often involves a detailed medical history, laryngoscopy, to view the throat, and sometimes esophageal pH monitoring to measure acid levels. Management of GERD-related tracheal symptoms typically includes lifestyle changes, such as dietary modifications and weight loss, along with medications that reduce stomach acid. In severe cases, surgery may be considered to prevent reflux. Managing GERD effectively is crucial to prevent complications and improve quality of life. So as you can see, the trachea plays a crucial role in the respiratory system and overall health. Disorders of the trachea, ranging from infections and inflammation to structural abnormalities and traumatic injuries, can have significant impacts on breathing and quality of life. Understanding the various disorders that can affect the trachea, their symptoms, and treatment options is essential for healthcare providers and patients alike. This knowledge not only aids in timely, effective treatment, but also underscores the importance of the trachea in respiratory health and the need for its protection and care. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. There should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.